My name is Tom Madden. I'm the team lead for the BLAST group at the NCBI. I'm going to tell you about using BLAST. I'm going to start with blasting into genomic datasets at the NCBI website. First, I'd like to thank Ben for inviting me to participate in this course. I'd also like to thank Peter Cooper, Tao Tao, and Wayne Matten for providing many of the examples I'm using here. I assume that most people are familiar with the BLAST website, but it's okay if you're not. You can learn on the job. First, I'm going to point my browser at blast.ncbi.nlm.nih.gov, and you'll get the page that you see right on your screen right here. At the top, you see genomes, and there's a number of genomes here, human, mouse, and such. And there's also a search box to find a genomic data set for any organism not listed here. We're going to come back to that in a little bit. Second, there are links for more traditional types of BLAST down below. And finally, there are specialized BLAST links down at the bottom. These links have to do with some BLAST variants or alignments. Now back to the top of the page. I'd like to search the genomic data set at the NCBI for Hydra vulgaris. All I have to do is start typing Hydra. And you see that I get a number of choices. And so I can select one, and so I'm going to look for Hydra vulgaris, and I can simply select it here. And then I type go. And the idea here is that this takes me to the best genomic set for Hydra vulgaris. And so I have it right here. By the way, Hydra vulgaris can regenerate its head, which I think would be a really awesome superpower. Anyway, now that I'm at the search page, I'd like to point out a few features. First, note that the menu has pre-selected the genome here. I can select the question mark and see some information on the assembly that I'll be searching. So what I'll do is I'm going to paste in an identifier from a TSA project, and TSA means transcriptome shotgun assembly. And so let me grab that identifier here, and I'm going to simply paste it in here. And so then I can just scroll down to the bottom of the page, and I can hit blast. So this should actually run pretty quickly, because it's a relatively small data set. Okay, so that didn't take too long, and I can see that I have matches to database sequences. We can see from the descriptions down here that these are unplaced genomic scaffolds. Let's take a quick look at the graphic up here. One of the database sequences is quite a bit longer, or one of the matches is quite a bit longer, and we see some vertical lines in the middle there. There's a vertical line there, there's another one. And these indicate missing sequence. Since the query here was an mRNA, and we're searching genomic sequences, I assume these are introns. Okay, so what I've done here is, to recap, is I've found a genomic assembly for Hydra vulgaris from the BLAST homepage, and I've searched it. Okay, so this genomic assembly was preliminary, but at least there was some assembly. It's a little different in some cases. For example, if I want to search another member of the Hydra genus, there might be less data. Say I want to look at Hydra oligactis. So in this case, the SRI data might be the best option. There are a number of ways to get to the data, but I'm going to start with the BLAST page, which you see in front of yourself. And so I'll go to the main BLAST page, and I'll select nucleotide BLAST here. And then what I'm going to do is change the menu to very bottom where it says sequence read archive. I see that there's a box to look for SRA accession or organism. So I'll start typing here, Hydra oligactis. So that's all I need to type. And so I see two choices. I'm going to take the first one here. And then I'm going to do the plus sign here. And do this again, Hydra oli. And I'm also going to select the second one. Now, okay, so then I'll put in the same query I had before. I'm just going to paste in that accession from the TSA. And I'm going to scroll down and hit BLAST. I get some results, but rather than look at those, I'd like to move on to looking at some human data with you. This is Tom Madden again, and we'll be looking at running standalone BLAST against SRA runs in this part of the course. First, I'd like to mention that there are a lot of helpful fact sheets on the NCBI FTP site.
And they're on the FTP site under pub/factsheets. Here we see the fact sheet about setting up local SRA BLAST. You'll find this one handy if you want to set up SRA BLAST on your own. So this next search involves looking at some metagenomic data for the human gut. And so I'm going to start with biosample. I've entered digestive decontamination as a query to biosample. So what I'll do is I'll run the search. And once I do that, I see there are 5 samples from one person. They're all at different points in time and place. At the top, I see 313 days at home. And at the bottom, I see 4 days in ICU. In between are 14 days, 16 days, and 28 days. I'm going to examine 16 days in ICU and at home. I'll use the SRA links here. And looking at the SRA pages, I can see the run accessions. So that's a run accession for the 16 days ICU. And the one for home I can find here. Also, again, this SRA link. And there's the SRA accession. As I've mentioned, we're going to work on standalone BLAST right now. To do this, I've started an instance at Amazon Web Services, or AWS. And I've installed the Linux SRA toolkit binaries there. So this is my instance at AWS. And by the way, I'd like to mention that we do have SRA binaries for PCs and Macs, so you could try searches on your desktop. Again, the fact sheet I mentioned earlier could help with this. I've also copied over a query that is supposed to help us identify antibiotic resistance, and here it is. For fun, you may want to try and find a different sequence to use as a query here. I'm going to run these searches with some parameters I saved to a file a bit ago. So let me copy over the first one here. And so a few comments on these parameters. The database name is actually the run accession. This is the query file I showed you before. I set the max target sequences to 5,000. That's 5,000 different runs I'm going to get results for. This out format 7 here gives me tabular output. I've set the E value here, the expect value, to 10 to the minus 6, so that I'm only looking for very significant matches. And the output will be saved in this file home 313 tab. So let me get this one going here. And while that's running, I'm also going to start the second one. So again, the run accession is the name of the database, and 5,000 target sequences, and very significant expect value. Okay, the searches are done. Right now, I'll just check the number of lines in each file. There are 68 lines in the 313-day home file and 576 lines in the 16-day ICU file. This looks like an interesting result about antibiotic resistance, but I'd call it preliminary, and there are any number of caveats here. One is that I might need to adjust for the differing sizes of the search sets. I checked, and they are both about the same size. Another question is whether we're simply looking at the amount of bacteroides in the sample. To check that, I'm going to run another search against a 16S sequence. I tried this and I know there are lots of matches. And so that's, since I know there are a lot of matches, I'm setting the max target sequences to 50,000 for this search. And all the other parameters are the same. And so that was the 313-day home runs. And this is for the 16-day ICU runs. And also, again, I've set max target sequences to 50,000. Now, actually, I'm pretty sure you could not do this on the NCBI website. It's a shared resource, so we limit the total CPU one process can take. Even if it ran, you might have a problem downloading the results. The good news with standalone BLAST is that you can abuse your system as much as you want, or your administrator permits you to. Okay, these results are done, so let's take a look. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to count the number of lines in the output file. And we see that the 16S 16-day results have about twice as many as the 313-day at-home results. Now, the 16-day antibiotic marker had about 9 times as many results as the 313-day. So maybe there's still something here, but it's not really clear-cut. Anyway, it does look like an interesting data set, and this shows you what kind of things you can do with SRA BLAST.